Peace and Shalom. This is Shemar Ma from the D.C. camp. We give all praises to Yahabah Shemiah Rashai. We give double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone. Peace and Shalom to the elect, to the men that's pushing this word throughout the four corners of the globe. You know, we come with salutations and exhortation, edification through the scriptures. We say Barakatah Yahweh, Barakatah Yahweh Shai, Barakatah Yahweh, Barakatah Yahweh Shai, Barakatah Yahweh, Barakatah Yahweh Shai. Again, with a lesson, real quick, real brief, but straight to the point. Entitled this, They Have No King But Caesar. They have no king but Caesar. You know, we're talking about the two-thirds. The two-thirds is a group of Israelites, the masses, the greater mass of the house of Israel, who believe that their king is Caesar. And Caesar, when you look up the word Caesar, Caesar just means an office. It was named after Julius Caesar at first. Went to Augustus and, you know, subsequent down to Augustus and Nero and Caligula. These were Caesars named after Julius Caesar, and they took on that name of the power and of the control that he had, that the office that he had, just like president, CEO. You know, it doesn't matter who the person is, but the office will be respected. And here in Babylon, you know, they respect, talking about the two-thirds, respect the office of Caesar. And also in ancient days, you know, we're talking about the time of David, talking about the time of our Lord Yahweh Shai, who they call Jesus. Yahweh had put these things, Yahweh being the Heavenly Father, had put these thoughts in the minds of the people of Israel to be a treasonous. And treasonous is people who are who've had a change in faith according to you know, what the standard of their office of who they are. They went against who they were, and they became treasonous to the Heavenly Father Yahabah Shemiah Shai and follow other gods. So, you know, this is the attitude of two-thirds. You know, it's a constant battle with unbelievers, with those who did believe. We're just going to go into the scriptures and hit a few points, you know, real quick. You know, it's to the point. First scripture I'm going to get is Matthew. This is Matthew 22 and 15. We're going to start from the beginning. Yahweh Shai, how he even had scoffers and scorners, two-thirds who try to trap him up. This is Matthew 22 and 15. Then went the Pharisees, talking about wicked Pharisees, because there were some good Pharisees and there were bad Pharisees. But here it says, then went the Pharisees and took counsel how they might entangle him in his talk, talking about Yahweh Shai, who the world calls Jesus. So they took a counsel to how to entangle him in his speech. Brothers know the story. You know, just going to get straight to the point. It says, and they went out unto him, their disciples with the Herodians, saying, Master, we know that you are true and teaches the way of Yahweh in truth. Neither carest thou for any man, for thou regardest not the person of men. So, you know, they're trapping him up, trying to see what, you know, where he's going to come with. You know, talking about he's true, his words are true. You know, trying to trap him up, trying to big him up with the talking out the side of their neck, being snakes. It says, tell us therefore, what thinkest thou? Is it lawful to give tribute unto Caesar or not? That's the question. It says, but Yahweh shall perceive their wickedness. See, they wasn't trying to be true. They were not trying to exalt him or get understanding from his teachings. They were trying to trap him up, and Yahweh Shai knew this, of course. He says, but Yahweh Shai perceived their wickedness and sent and said, why temptest me, thou hypocrites? You know, they being actors. That's what hypocrite means, to be an actor. It says, show me the tribute money. And they bought, Salah. Tell us therefore, verse 17, tell us therefore, what thinkest thou? Is it lawful to give tribute unto Caesar or not? But Yahusha perceived their wickedness and said, why tempt ye me, ye hypocrites? Show me the tribute money. And they brought unto him a penny. And he said unto them, whose is the image and superscription? They said unto him, Caesar's. Then said he unto them, render therefore unto Caesar the things which are Caesar's, and unto Yahweh the things that are Yahweh's. So they're trying to trap him up to find out, should we pay tribute money? Because, you know, if he would say, yeah, pay him the tribute money, oh, we got him, see? This is the Lord telling us to be under Caesar. But he said, give Caesar what's his. Caesar is just an office. It's just an office. So what he was trying to say is, you give to Caesar tribute, meaning you give him the reverence. You give him what belongs to him, right? Give to Yahweh what's Yahweh's. So what is Yahweh's? What's Yahweh's tribute money? What is his treasure? We are his treasure. Yahweh, talking about the Israelites, the men of Israel, the true brethren. We are his treasure. He says this in Psalms. But going on, you know, this tribute money, it has no meaning, just like today. It's just fiat money. It has no value. This is tribute to the Caesar, to the office, right? And Caesar relies on his tribute money coming in from the other nations and from all his subjects. But Yahweh wants his tribute money also. He wants his treasure to give to him. So what who's his treasure? We're going to get it. This is Psalms 135:4. It says, for Yahweh had chosen Jacob unto himself and Israel for his peculiar treasure. For I know that Yahweh is great and that our power is above all gods. Lowercase g. Because the other nations' gods are no gods. So we're his treasure. We're his peculiar treasure. So what we're supposed to do is give ourselves to Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, and not only to him, but the edification of our people. This is the whole point of giving yourself up. This is your duty. This is your duty. Follow the commandments and continue doing this work until the kingdom come, for the salvation of Israel. But we're talking about the elect. So you're giving yourself up, right? You're using your body as the sacrifice. You see? So, continuing on, because the gods of the other nations are not gods, you see? So, when you're giving tribute to Caesar, you're giving tribute to what he want to do. And he don't believe in Yahweh Bashim Yahushua. So, you're giving tribute to nothing. Basically, you're giving the treasure to him. You're giving it to Caesar or the office, whoever that may be. We're going to jump down Psalm 135. In 15, it says, the idols of the heathens are silver and gold. You see what I'm saying? The idols of the other nations are silver and gold. Tribute money. And this is what you've given to them, tribute money. You're not supposed to give yourself to them because you're not money for him. You're money for Yahweh Bashim Yahushua. You're the treasure for Yahweh Bashim Yahushua and your nation, standing up for your nation. You see? It says the work of men's hands. Silver and gold is just the work of men's hands. Has nothing to do with Yahweh Bashim Yahushua. It says, verse 16, they have mouths, but they speak not. Eyes have they, but they see not. Talking about building up these idols, whatever they may be, democracy, homosexuality, all his ideologies. Right, his education system. This is you're going to pay tribute to this. This has nothing to do with righteousness or salvation. This doesn't uplift your people by giving yourself unto their idols. You see, verse 17 says they have ears,
but they hear not, neither there any breath in their mouth.
Verse 18, they that make them are like unto them, so is everyone that trusteth in them. So basically, when you trust in these other idols, when you give yourself to as a tribute to Caesar or the office of Caesar, you become nothing. And that's the nation of Israel. We have become nothing because we've given all ourselves to these other nations, to this office of Caesar. So 2/3 of our people have become a tribute to Caesar. Caesar became their god, you see? And it's only one power, Yahweh Hashem El Shai. What is Deuteronomy 6 and 4 said? Right? Yahweh Shammai, Yasha Allah, Yahweh, Allah Hayanawa, Yahweh Achad. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our power. Our power is one. Yahweh Hashem El Shai. This is our one power. Not Caesar's office. So what you've done, talking about 2/3 of our people have committed treason. Treason. Look up the etymology of treason. Is a betrayal of trust, a betrayal, a breach of faith, treachery. Right, a handing over or delivering, surrendering. You surrendering to nothing, to false gods, to a false office. Instead of giving yourself your life, your everything, who you become, right, is for another god. So you're following and becoming of the other nation. This is how you become Gentile. Instead of following the law, statute, commandments, and being circumcised in the heart, mind, and soul to Yahweh Hashem El Shai. You see? You've become another creature. You become what the vision of Peter has seen, knitted at the four corners, all types of creeping beasts. All types of abominable beasts. This is what you've become by following the other nations. We're going to read Acts 17, because Acts 17, you know, this is what, you know, our people have done, always trying to trap us up, just like the Pharisee, the wicked Pharisee, try to do with Yahweh Shai. This is what our nation, our own nation within us. This internal struggle in the nation of Israel has always done with us. It's always been enmity, even within us, our own nation. And you had men always coming against the men of the Lord. This is natural. This is what is going to be until Yahweh Shai comes back. So, you know, you have to prepare yourself, your mind, your spirit, that these things is going to happen. Through much tribulation, we're going to enter into the kingdom of heaven. This is Acts 17 and 1. It says, now when they had passed through Amphipolis and Apollonia, they came to Thessalonica, where was a synagogue of the Jews. And Paul, as his manner was, went in unto them, and three Sabbath days reasoned with them out of the scriptures, opening and alleging that Hamashiach Yahweh Shai must needs have suffered and risen again from the dead, and that this Yahweh Shai, whom I preach unto you, is the anointed. It says, and some of them believed, and consorted with Paul and Silas, and of the devout Greeks, a great multitude, and of the chief women, not a few. So there was many people who believed. And these Greeks, because they was in Greece, up in the Greek land, Apollonia, Thessalonica, Berea, these was in lands of the Greeks, or heavily Greek influenced lands. But this word Greek, when it says devout Greeks, we're talking about Hellenists. We're talking about Israelites who took on a Greek philosophy, because the Greek philosophy was heavy in these lands. So when we were scattered because of our wickedness, these lands became Hellenized by the Greeks, talking about Antiochus, And even going all the way back to Alexander, who started this Hellenization of the people, which means following Greek fashion and Greek ideas, even speaking Greek, becoming Greek, dressing Greek. Your culture is now Greek, okay? And basically you become in another office again. Once again, you're talking about Israelites who fell away from them, from their power, from their one God, right? And become some other creature. And this other creature was Hellenists, Greeks, okay? Gentiles in this New Testament, okay? Because Gentile really means foreigner, right? And when you look up Gentilis, it just means foreigner. And when you're a foreigner, you're foreign from what? What you originally was. What you originally was Israelites. Now you become foreigners or Greeks or Hellenists or Gentiles. You see? This is who you become, a whole nother creature. Yahweh Shem Hoshai has given us law, statute, and commandments through Moses to be a peculiar people, a special treasure, but you've become something else. Verse 5, it says, but the Jews which believe not, it's always an antagonist, even within ourselves, because Yahweh is perfect balance. He's always going to have an antagonist. There's always going to be the righteous and the wicked, the up and the down, the left and the right, the hot and the cold. You see, the dark and the night is always that way. That's perfect balance. This is what you call having all control, perfect balance. Okay? Even in your spirit, a man in the Lord has to have that balance. You got to find that balance within yourself, because when you control your spirit, you become a better person, a better spiritual man. Understanding of the law, statute, commandments, and judgments. You become discerned. You can understand the differences between what's right and what's wrong when you have a perfect balance. It says, but the Jews, which believe not, moved with envy, took unto them certain lewd fellas of the baser sort, talking about wicked ass niggas, to be really specific with it, to be really blunt with it. Talking about lewd fellas of baser sort, talking about niggas, straight niggas. It says, and they gathered a company, right, mob up, and set all the city in uproar, and assaulted the house of Jason, and sought to bring them out to the people. And when they found them not, they drew Jason and certain brethren unto the rulers of the city, crying, these that have turned the world upside down are come hither also, whom Jason have received, and these all do contrary to the decrees of Caesar, saying that there is another king, one Yahweh Shai. This is what they're saying. You could just hear it. You can just hear it through these scriptures when you put your mind to it, when you have that spirit. You could just hear these niggas saying, look, Jason, what the hell you doing? You got these men coming up in your house saying that there's another God, there's another king? What are you doing? Caesar's our king. What are you doing? Wicked ass people, wicked Israelites. It says, and when they found them not, they drew Jason and certain brethren, talking about Paul, and they were looking for him, right? It says, brethren unto the ruler of the city, crying, these that have turned the world upside down are come hither also, whom Jason had received, and these all do contrary to the decrees of Caesar. So they want to follow Caesar's rules instead of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai rules, being Israelites. How wicked is that? Saying that there is another king, one Yahweh Shai, and they troubled the people and the rulers of the city when they heard these things. And when they had taken security of Jason and of the other, they let them go because they had nothing on them. You know, basically what Jason did was receive Paul and Silas, right? And a lot of people started believing in Paul and Silas about this man, Yahweh Shai, to come for the salvation of Israel. So they were saying that these men were making an uproar of the people instead of following Caesar. Another office. That's just wickedness, man. But it's always like that. It's always an antagonist, even amongst Israel. You know, there's the truth, there's the righteous, right? And there's wickedness and the unrighteous. There's wickedness and the unrighteous. Always. It's always two and two. We're going to get that scripture because, you know, this is the basis of the lesson. You know, there's always going to be that two and two, that balance. So it's going to be a side that you're going to be on. Now, hopefully you be on the righteous side because the righteous side is the path to salvation. This is Sirach 33 and 10. It says, "And all men are from the ground, and Adam was created of earth. In much knowledge the Lord, Yahweh, Shemah, and Shai, had divided them and made their ways diverse." Yahweh Shai always going to be that way. He's always cutting and splitting up the people because he has a purpose, you know. He has a will. He has a purpose. So his purpose is to chisel up what he wants. He has a particular treasure. He has a particular people. You see, he has an elect. These separate from the rest. It says, "Some of them has he blessed and exalted, and some of them he sanctified and set near himself." Talking about Israel. And not only Israel, but the elect of Israel. Because remember, there's always an antagonist within the within. It's always, okay? "But some of them he had cursed and brought low and turned out of their places. As the clay is in the potter's hand to fashion it as his pleasure, so man is in the hand of him that made him to render to them as like of him best. Good is set against evil and life against death. So is the godly against the sinner and the sinner against the godly. So look upon all the works of the Most High, Yahweh Shem Shai, and there are two and two, one against another." So there's going to be people who always take to the office of Caesar or another nation or another people or another culture. And it's going to be some that is going to be drawn to Yahweh Shem Shai, talking about who the world called God and Jesus. This is you know, his heavenly son. There's always going to be this splitting, always going to be this division, even amongst Israel. But like I said before, what side are you going to be on? The side of righteousness or the side of wickedness and the other nations? See, the other nations and wickedness is going to be destroyed. Righteousness is going to flourish. Righteousness is going to be saved in the day of turmoil, in the day of Jacob's trouble, in the day of reckoning, the day of judgment. You see, so it all depends on what side you're going to be on. Yahweh Shem Yahshua has set you on the side. Now you have to walk ye in it, you see. So, you know, like I said from the title, it says there is only one king. Caesar is our power. So that's the two-thirds. But we know our power, Yahweh Shem Shai, the men is pushing this word in sincerity and truth throughout the four corners of the earth that we give salutations to. We're talking about the apostles of Great Millstone who teach us well, who teach us how to break down these scriptures and understand this Heavenly Father's word. You know, and all the men that's pushing this word, we say Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shai. Call Halal Yahweh Shem Shai. All praises to Yahweh Shem Shai for giving us this gift of understanding and truth and edification in these scriptures. We not on Caesar's side. We give all tribute to Caesar, but we give Yahweh Shem Shai our lives, our time, our energy, our spirit. We give everything to Yahweh Shem Shai. We give everything to him. That tribute money is not money. We're the money, and we give everything to Yahweh Shem Yahshua when it comes to tribute. With that, we say Shalom.